when we use a while loop, it is possible that we can't even go to the while loop because the condition stated in the while loop is already violated at the very beginning. So if we want to make sure that we run the while loop at least once, we can have another way to do so. We can use a do while loop. Let us see how we can implement a do while loop. Suppose I'm going to count the number of people. So I set up a variable which is initialized to be 0. I can do a do while loop like this. Do I want to print out the content stored in the variable by using the print line command. And then I want to increment the people by 1 after the printing statement. So I can use the num people++. So after printing out the number of people, I will add 1 to the variable stored in the numPeople variable. So is it able to stop the addition and printing? Yes, we can make some constraint to it by saying the condition. While numPeople is smaller than or equal to 4. So you can expect that the printing will stop when numPeople becomes 4. Let us run it and see the result. Yes, numPeople will stop at 4. Because when numPeople becomes 5, this part is violated. And let us do the dry running. NumPeople 0, so 0, and now NumPeople becomes 1. We go back to the beginning and we will print out 1, and then now NumPeople becomes 2, and then we go to the beginning, we print 2, and then NumPeople becomes 3, so we print 3, and NumPeople becomes 4. And we go to 4, and then numPeople would become 5. So when numPeople becomes 5, this condition is violated, so the looping will stop, and the final value to print out will be 4. Of course, when we do a while loop or a do while loop, we have to take care of the situation when the loop never ends. How about this situation? Suppose I change the condition to this one. NumPeople larger than or equal to minus 4. So NumPeople starts with 0, and it will do the addition by 1 continuously. And when we do the addition, the NumPeople variable will have a value being always larger than or equal to minus 4. So this condition will always hold for the content inside the do while loop. So we will never be able to stop the program because this condition is always satisfied. So let us see what I will get. Let me clean the console first by right-clicking and choosing clear. And let me save the source code and let me run it. Okay, the process continues all the time, so I have to stop it by clicking on the terminate button here. So you can see that the number is ever increasing and this condition will always hold. So in this case, we will result in an endless loop, which is not our preferred solution to a particular program. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.